here he comes, the big man from Kazakhstan, Oleg Maskayev, looking to get back up on that horse one more time. He's had that several times throughout his career. His first knockout loss coming at the hands of Oliver McCall in only a seventh pro fight back in February of 96. He came back only to get stopped by David Tour in 97, came back, and then went on a terrific win streak with some major knockouts, including Derek Jefferson, and of course the devastating out-of-the-ring knockout of Haseem Rahkhmen in 99, only to be knocked out by Kirk Johnson in October of last year, the fourth round, and looking totally lethargic against Lance Mount Whitaker, getting stopped this past March in two rounds. Ryan Nix, you see him there. He's in the biggest fight of his life. Coming in tonight, 15-7. He's got a four-fight win streak going. However, every time he seems to step up, whether it's against Terrence Lewis or Ron Guerrero, both of who we saw tonight, or Al Cole, seems to come up just a little bit short. How do they match up on paper, though? Maskayev giving up 15 pounds in weight to Nix. They're both 6'3". Reaches about even, age is about the same. So the age, the weight may be a factor, and that's actually a decent weight for Brian Nix based on his last fights. We're in Nevada, no standing eight count here. There is no three knockdown rule. You cannot be saved by the bell as we saw in the last fight. Only the referee can stop the fight. Should the heads come together, cause a cut, we're under four rounds. It's gonna be a technical draw. Otherwise, we're going to the scorecards. Now up to our official introductions from our ring announcer, the magnificent Mark Biro.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cedric Kushner Promotions in association with the fabulous Flamingo Laughlin presents the Everlast Heavyweight Explosion main event of the evening, 10 rounds. Your referee for this event, the pride of Laughlin, Nevada, Jay Nady. Introducing now the principals first, in the blue corner to my left, wearing the gold trunks with the black trim and weighing in at 249 pounds with a professional record of 15 victories, 7 defeats, 3 knockouts. He hails from Rochester, New York. Here is Brian Big Man Nix. Nix. His opponent in the red corner, wearing the black trunks, weighing in at 234 pounds, with a professional record that reads 20 victories, 4 defeats, 15 wins coming by way of knockout. He hails from Kazakhstan, Russia, and now boxes out of Staten Island, New York. Introducing heavyweight contender, Oleg Maskayev. Maskayev, 10 rounds, heavyweight.
You guys mouthpiece? All right, do we have any questions? 10 rounds, obey my commands. I can see your belly button there, so it's going to be below there on the black. See yours there, all right? Good luck, touch gloves, let's go to work.
All right, very pensive Brian Nix. You see Tommy Parks in his corner, former trainer of Bobby Chez. Oleg Maskayev, a loss tonight would ultimately end his career. This is the get up on your horse. Kevin, you think it's the right fight back? We talked about that in the open.
You never know.
It's been an interesting night, though, of close fights and upsets. Maskayev,
like I said, it's a
coming
right
out
fight.
Rather tentative, and Nick's coming out winging.
Like I said, it's the right fight if he wins. It's the wrong fight if he loses. So you can't tell. One shot can end anything. The heavyweight.
Maskayev looking very dry.
He's also moving away from the right hand. He's not trying to get hit with the right hand. He's stepping to his right, trying to get away from Brian Nix's right hand. You know, even though he's not really worried about it that much, Brian Nix only has 3 knockouts. But can't take chances, you know? shot from anywhere can catch you, especially at this weight, can take you out.
Nix has been in with some good heavyweights. David Bastos, Al Cole, Ron Guerrero, who we saw tonight, Terrence Lewis, although on the losing end where those names are concerned. Winova Maskayev would be huge for him. A loss for Maskayev would be devastating for him. Very slow and tentative first half of this round for Maskayev.
He doesn't like it won't go properly in the dressing room. And also no beads of sweat on his head or anything. And he's stiff as it is, Maskayev. He's very stiff. European fighter with Uncle Al Gavin and Bob Jackson did a great job with him as far as trying to westernize him, as they call it. Make him box like an American.
Had the opportunity to go down to Gleason's gym last week, watch Maskayev work out. I asked him who he was fighting. I knew who he was fighting. But he didn't. So
he didn't care.
He did not care. Studied no tapes of Brian Nix, who tries to throw the right hand lead right there and catches Maskayev walking in. Very workmanlike. Maskayev starting to find the range right now, closing the distance between the two of them. 45 seconds to go in the first. Jane 80 separates the fighters.
I realize that jab a little bit more on Maskayev. And coming behind the jab, all the way right. Catch it right there, just did it right there. And keep Nix off balance.
Nix stopped two times in his career, once by Jamil McCline in his pro debut back in October of 95, and then by the former cruiserweight champion Al Cole up in Montreal on the explosion in November of 99. Nix was having a good fight against Cole that night, too. Very close fight when he got stopped. Remember, Kevin? Good first round for Nix. Oh, whenever we say that, right hand punctuates the end for Maskayev.
Guy's laying there for that uppercut, but it's the left uppercut. When you're up close and you're putting your hand under, his head is right here. When you get up close, I want you to hit that left hip and pull that left uppercut. Got me? The jab is good. Punch a little crisper off it.
Right. You start going right hand, pick a left right hand over there, then punch. You got me?
Yeah.
You got easy. This is easy if you do it.
Right there for you, man. Right there for you. Knock that bum out, man.
Right there. Right there.
Seconds out. We approach the second round.
We start round number two. Tommy Parks in the corner of Brian Nix saying this could be easy. Different instructions in the corner of Maskayev. Bob Jackson looking for a left uppercut on the inside, Kevin.
Yeah, Brian Nix is dropping his head. And I don't know what the train of Brian Nix is saying, but Kevin, I think he feels that Maskayev's a little tender.
Maskayev just threw that left uppercut. Now he tries the right, just for good measure.
And it lands. Maskayev was very stiff here. There he goes, when he loses, utilizes the jab, he looks very effective, and punches off the jab.
Kevin, that's one of the questions we talked about a little in the open. How well can you come back from two devastating knockouts? We talk sometimes about a guy coming back from one, but back-to-back knockouts from Kirk Johnson and Mount Whitaker.
Yeah, he actually doesn't look too aggressive here, like looking to give him a punch. He looks very tender. He lands a shot and walks away, and that's what fighter shows. They're not looking to mix it up.
Not to mention the fact that he lost, that he, you know, he beat the man who beat the man, and he's got nothing to show for it. Knocked Kasim Rockman out of the ring.
Ain't that something? Shows the comeback. The pressure mark is getting old. Massive comeback and getting knocked out twice. That's the question.
A lot of boxing history needs to be written before the two of them can get back in the ring, of course. Rockman's got that rematch with Lewis coming up, but should Maskayev be able to put together two or three wins and Rockman win the rematch, then you might be able to see Maskayev Rockman 2 for the heavyweight championship. But like we said, a lot of boxing history has to be written. Of course, Moskav's got to win his fights, and of course, Rockman has to win that rematch with Lewis. And then, of course, the proposed Tyson-Rockman fight. Should it get to that? Right now, we're for Ringo Laughlin with a minute to go in the second round, and we get to see a fight really break out here between these two.
Moskav, man, very good power shots. I think his confidence is coming back a little bit. He's getting more aggressive here. Throwing very powerful shots. He's picking the shots, not being overdone. He's being cautious.
He's having a much better second round than he had first.
He's definitely trying to build his confidence up. Not taking this fight for granted, I'll tell you that.
That would be a mistake. Low blow in there by Ryan Nix. No warning from Jay Nady. I hadn't realized that Nady was involved in the matter, as Mark Bureau pointed out in our introductions. Much better round for the Russian. Oh, and he catches. Oh, and he catches Nix on the way in, and his legs do a little dance.
Nick's legs actually don't look that good anyway. They're too long.
He's still out of range, though. Put your hands up here. If you throw right in, put your hands right here. Okay? Then you gotta come back. It's on the head. Take a look at you. Brian.
Huh?
If you're gonna throw that right hand, touch him with it.
Huh?
Come back an inside hook.
Huh?
Straight as you can. You hear me?
Yeah.
Good shot, Jab. And don't let him walk you backwards all the time. Put some power to him, ba ba bam, and step to the side. All right? Breath. Come on, look like a fighter now. Good shot, Jab.
Seconds out. Seconds out. We approach the third round.
Round number three, Oleg Moskayev, solid black. Ryan Nix, gold and black stripe. Second round, all Moskayev as he really started to get his rhythm down, Kevin.
Yeah, well, Bob Jackson gave him very good instruction. He said, I want you to hit him and step to the side. What Moskayev is doing is he's hitting and he's stepping back. But what happens is you lose range of motion. You lose his range and the distance of your fighter. You land a good shot, wobble back. Move to the side and land again.
Some frustration in the voice of Jackson from the last two fights because he ended there with his between rounds instructions with act like a fighter.
Yeah, well, they don't want him to be so passive as he's being. They want him to be a little more aggressive and take control of this fight. I mean, you know, he looks very tentative in this fight. And he's worried about Ryan's punching power, which he should be. They want him in there banging Ryan's out and get out of there and show that you are back.
Moskayev rocked Nix at the end of the second round. Nix going, that's not only out having any ill effects, but coming out as good as he looked at the beginning of the first.
Well, the longer the fight goes, the worse it is for Moskayev, because he's got to make a statement. Look impressive to get back in that mix of things. That's especially being knocked out back to back.
Nice right over the top by Moskayev. Catches.
Stop! Wait!
Nix holding on right there right now.
Three
very shaky legs right now. I'm telling you that right hurt. But Nix.
Yeah, Nix legs. So his legs are shaky when he starts the fight. Leg walks on his heels a little bit. He doesn't like have strong legs at all. Support him. And, all it takes to me is a good shot from Moskayev, and it could be over for Nix.
Also, it would be a good yardstick to measure just how back Moskayev is, because Nix only stopped that one time by Al Cole up in Montreal. He's been some good heavyweights. As we mentioned, including Terrence Lewis and Ryan Guerrero, both had himself tonight. Neither of them stopped Nix. Nice combination by Moskayev. Oh, good combinations on the inside. Nix in big trouble. Little less than a minute to go here in the third.
Moskayev can use control. He might produce a knockout here, but if he can, he's got to also be careful. I'm sure the boxing believe that he has a Christian chin theory, you know, saying he's hit with a shot, he goes down.
Moskayev really having his way right now. Under 30 seconds to go here in the third, and Nix holding on profusely. Nady has his work cut out for him. experience. You saw him time Nick's on the way in.
That's why I want to step into the side.
Big round for the Russian.
Hey, Phil. Hey, listen.
What?
Listen. You're not using your left hip, though. If you get on that hip, under that right hand, it worked. You're going to stop him quick. You're getting up close, and instead of being on the hip.
Action early in the third round. Maskayev serving notice at that point. Kevin, he's using that uppercut. Listen very well to what his corner told him.
Very good. He's very patient. Like I said, he's used that experience. Ryan Nixon's never been in a ring with a fighter like Maskayev. And I believe that, you know, this could be very good for Maskayev. He can actually finish off Ryan Nixon if he comes.
Round number four, and Maskayev gave us a look over, Kevin, as all this to say, how am I doing?
I think he knows how he's doing, like I said. I think his confidence is coming back, as you can see in the fight. He's getting more aggressive. He's taking more risks, more chances. He still don't want to step back like he is right there. He needs to step to his left and go to the right hand. That's the one. I think Ryan Nix is not in the Maskayev league to defeat him tonight. Plus shots. He steps back. When he steps back, he loses his range. When you lose range, you can't finish him in. He's timing him, he's loading him up, he's setting him up. With the right hand, Ben. He's a nice mother that time, but you know, he's got to work on this. He's got to work on things.
Nice hook off the jab by Maskayev.
But he steps back in line. That's not what Ball Jackson wants. He wants him to hit him like that, for a good combination, uppercut or hook, and then step to the side.
Nice pulling back, so we've got him in trouble, both with Whitaker.
Don't you have to extend a punch? Don't you have to end up a guy's punch? And when you have to end a guy's punch, that's where the power is. That's how you get beat.
To the side nicely there now. Really very heavy at this point in his mouth. Really starting to take a beating. Taking some big shots from Maskayev.
Step back. I guess they feel that Maskayev can be more of a dominant force. Be more rectifying.
Nix can't wait to get back on the inside and hold on. And Nady really having his work cut out for him. He has trouble even separating them.
Nix is getting hit with very good hard shots. Maskayev really looking sharp. I said, his confidence coming back. This is actually a good fight for him.
Watch for Nady to give a warning though for holding on to Nix.
He definitely needs to work on this stepping back. And stepping back is not going to be effective in the future.
He stepped to the side, he would negate also to hold him on.
Exactly.
He's sitting there right. So he lands one shot, and Nix is on top of him, able to wrestle with him, Kevin. Under 20 seconds to go here in the fourth.
Nick's legs are looking good on his
front
shot. Nick's legs are
Nick's holding on big time.
Nick's legs are definitely trying.
Maskayev just can't get the room to let the big shot go. Nevertheless, good round for Olaf Maskayev.
You're letting him get too close to you without you punching.
All right.
Tom, you gotta give me the punch.
Dry or wet?
Or wet, like that. Brian, you gotta punch this guy all the time. You're just laying.
Fake the right. Come under with the right uppercut and back with the hook. Got me?
Look at Donnie. Look at the shots here. Maskayev is, when he punches and he lands good shots, he steps right back in the line. He's very effective when he lands his shots, but Bob Jackson.
You're wearing him down now. Come on. How you doing, good?
Hot, man. And approach the fifth round.
Gaev off his stool early here in the fifth round, meeting Nix in the center of the ring. He gets into that zone, Kevin. We've seen Gaev a lot. You can almost tell when he wants to end it.
Oh, he wants definitely end it now. Like I said, the quicker he can get Brian excited, the better he looks. He's up in the fifth round already of a 10-round fight, and he needs a fight to bring him back to show him. Gaev can definitely come back. No ill effects from the two knockouts.
Stop!
He needs to make a statement. He definitely needs to make a statement.
Certainly, Nick's going the distance with him would have to be the statement that he's looking for.
It's kind of weird and peculiar that if he produces a knockout, he makes a statement and he wins the fight. If he wins the fight and wins a decision, there's no statement. It's kind of weird. He can win a fight either way. He's still one end is negative and other end is positive. So he's got to win by knockout. And not be knocked
out. There he goes again. Maskayev catches Nix walking straight in. We might be breaking some sort of a record for clinches here on the explosion tonight.
Ryan Nix's legs don't look too healthy today. They're kind of shaky. And, unless he gets careless. Like I said, it could be a lucky shot by Nix. He's only got three knockouts, but he is a heavyweight.
This guy has slipping those shots nicely, but not coming up throwing anything. Yeah, I see that a lot. Slip. When they don't come up throwing, it's almost like it could be timed on the way back up.
Exactly. It's called make a miss, make him pay. You have to live by that rule.
Very shaky legs on Nix. Shot coming in.
Let's see what can go through his round. I mean, both men have been hurt. Can Nix come back and recover?
Well, we're in the second half of the scheduled 10 rounder. A lot of interesting things going on in Nix's corner between rounds. Tommy Park's very concise in his instructions. Don't let him hit you with the right hand, says Kevin.
He just said that.
He didn't tell him how not to get hit with it. He said, just don't get hit with the right hand. Jay Nady comes in, though, and says, where are you? He says, I'm in Las Vegas. But right now, he's not sure where he is. As he goes down, Nady anticipating the drop. Come on, Oscar, away from him.
He saved him, maybe. He can get him around. He has to hold his breath.
Oscar, have a big finisher. Taking off where he left off in the fifth. Nate's going to take a good hard look here. Don't be surprised if he stops this fight.
Nick's has to grab and hold.
Oh, Nick's out on his feet right now. That's it. The fight's over. Very good stoppage on the part of Jay Nady. As Oleg Maskayev becomes only the second man to stop Brian Nix here in the sixth round in what we would say in the store what Brian Nix called Lapland. I'm in Lapland. Well, he's still in Laughlin here at the Flamingo. And Oleg Maskayev back on track. Is it enough to get him to the rematch for the heavyweight championship against Asim Rockman?
I don't think so.
Not yet, but
I believe
he's got some time now, Kevin. That fight's not scheduled till November.
I think a 3-4 more fights, beating somebody in the top 10, will be fighting. Look at his stoppage here. I mean, look at the punch. Boom. Overhand right, right behind the jab. Hook. Nick's legs deceive him. He goes down. When he goes down, he recovers a little bit. I can see. Here's the finish of the fight. You see the uppercuts. Maskayev landing at will. Whatever punch he wants to land, when he wants to land it, referee steps in and saves Nick's.
Not only a good stoppage on the part of Jay Nady, but very good anticipation of the droppage.
Welcome back.
Bob Jackson above us saying, well, he said, welcome back to Oleg Maskayev. It had to be a very frustrating last two fights. Steve Trudnov, the manager of Oleg Maskayev, smiling. And Steve doesn't smile very easily, and he's very happy right now above us. And again, they had back-to-back devastating knockout losses to Johnson and Whitaker. Very tough for a management and training team to take. Typical stoic Maskayev, though, almost giving a smile and a grin. He won't allow himself that. He'll allow that only when perhaps he's won the heavyweight championship and or settled the scores with Johnson and Whitaker. Official time of the stoppage. We're going to go up to our ring announcer, the magnificent Mark Bureau.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time, 53 seconds of the sixth round. The winner by technical knockout, Oleg Maskayev.
All right, Maskayev will improve to 21-4. That's his 16th win by knockout. Dropping down to 15-8 is Brian Nix. Took a terrible beating in there tonight, but showed a lot of heart in the process.